Hello students, welcome to e-padasala. I Dr. V. Ramesh Babu, associate professor from Department of Textile Technology, Kumarur College of Technology, Coimbatore. Today we are going to discuss the chapter on evolution of color fastness. In this lecture we are going to discuss the various topics. The first one is definition on color fastness to washing, grayscale assessment, color fastness to rubbing, color fastness to light, and color fastness to perspiration. Color fastness is the property of dye that enables to retain its color in original depth and tone throughout the wear life of the product to which it has been applied. It means that whenever you're going to buy the fabric or garment after frequent laundering or some other use, the color should not be faded out. It should be stick on the fabric. It should not be bleeded to some other metal or fabric too. So that's what definition says, the property of pigment or dye to retain its original hue, especially with fading, running or changing when wetted, washed, cleaned, so stored under normal condition or when exposed to light, heat or other influence, not only to laundering, even for light or for heat or other rubbing or by means of sweating also, the colors should not be faded. That is the ultimate purpose of color fastness test. Color fastness of dyed textile. There are so many agencies that are going to affect the color fastness. The main four parameters what we are going to discuss in this lecture, that is color fastness to washing, because every garment should be washed after the use, and color fastness to rubbing. All the garment that we are going to wear anyway, they are going to be rubbed in metal parts while sitting in chairs or tables or when we are moving. So because of this, the fabric going to be abraded with some other elements, the color might be faded. Color fastness light. In daytime, we will be exposed to the sunlight or some other tube light or any source of light. Because of that light, there might be change in color variations. And color fastness to perspiration. This happens because of sweat in the body or because of liquid that going to generate so many resources. So this is going to affect the bleeding or say difference in the. So first we can see one by one color fastness to washing. It is nothing but ability of the fabric to withstand the effect of laundering. That is nothing but effect of washing. Normally in home we are going to do the washing by using detergent for half an hour or 1 hour. In that time, how the color going to be the fabric, whether it be said difference will be happen or going to be say bleed or something like that we have to check. For measuring this industry using laundrometer to evaluate the color fastness with the help of grayscales. The washing of fabric results in removal of dye, therefore staining can occur. See, anyway after washing the dye going to be come out of the fabric, because of this this dye going to be stick on the other fabric. In order to determine the staining, a white multi-fiber strip is attached to the specimen being tested to CF2 washing, that is named color fastness too. So this is basic test procedure prescribed by AATCC, where we are going to cut the specimen to 2 into 6 inches. This is for multi-fiber strip. In the multi-fiber strip, there will be so many fabric attached with that fiber, viscose, wool, cotton, like that, nylon. So more than 6 strips will be there. So that dimension is going to be 2 into 6 inches. So the procedure is very simple. The figure shows that there are a laundrometer. The laundrometer there will be a water bath. In the water bath we are going to place the sample. The sample is going to rotate in the water bath, where the water is going to be heated by the heating element. The temperature will be raised based on the necessary parameters that we required. The temperature may be raised in 40 degree to 100 degree centigrade. The water bath going to be rotate where the actual laundering taking place in the home, the simulation of the laundering taking place in the home. So due to this, the color going to be bleed or stain on the adjacent fabric. So these are the 5 test, washing tests prescribed by the AATCC. This is for, we can do the test method in 2 form. One, we can attach the multi-fiber fabric with the fabric that what we are going to test, or we can attach the cotton fabric to the fabric what we are going to test. If you are going to attach the cotton fabric, these are the 5 tests prescribed by the AATCC, where you are going to choose. For first 3 we are going to choose wool fabric, and 4 and 5 we are going to choose viscose fabric, and The percentage of detergent they have mentioned, and material to liquid temperature they have mentioned, and time of rotating that water bath they have mentioned. And sometimes you're going to add steel balls to give abrasion in the fabric, so that going to give for heavy fabric. And finally, they mentioned the material liquid ratio what you have to follow, 1:50. Any method you can choose based on the end use of the garment. So, evaluation of colour portion to washing, the assessment of colour portion carried out by assigning rating for the two aspects. So, two things can be happened when we're going to wash the garment: the change in colour from the base fabric, or the staining from the colour bleeding from the base fabric going to be attached to some other fabric. So, the two things we're going to measure: the staining effect on each fibre in the cotton or multi-fibre test fabric should be rated using grayscale. It is checked after which the effect of bleeding or color migration. So for this, AITCC 124 standards were used. So grayscale, this is very important. Arrangement of achromatic grayscale from light to dark. So 9 pairs of non-glossary neutral gray color chips with illustrate and perceived color difference, giving a corresponding color fastness rating of 5, 4 to 5, 4, 3 to 4, 3, 2 to 3, 2, 1 to 2 and 1. How to use the grayscale? Use a class of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 rating system. Class 5 is very simple. If you're going to check the sample after finishing the laundrometer process, and we take that sample, dry it, and we're going to compare with the grayscale, and if it is matching 5 means it is good, it matching 1 means it is worst. So sometimes half rating also should be given in between 3 to 4, 4 to 5, and 4 to 5, like that. So clearly state 5 is excellent, 4 is good, 3 is fair, 2 is poor, and 1 is very poor. Specimen of given hue are matched against these gray chips. This equate difference in lightness with difference in color. So method of testing: a control fabric is used, usually white or undyed, also assessed for the staining which results from the contact with the test. See, this is nothing but if the color beads, that going to affect the adjacent white fabric. Result assessed by grading against A04 and 05. Grade 5 is no change in color, or it is not stained. Grade 1 means there will be drastic difference in the color. Usually one specimen of fabric used. If material dyed or printed uniformly throughout the fabric, the specimen chosen should be representative of the entire lot. That is very important when doing sampling. You should not cut the material at the selvages. It should be in the center of the fabric, and it should be in the random way. So multi-color printed fabric, each color should be, sometimes printed fabric there will be 6 or 8 colors. So in that case we cannot check cut the fabric and check. We have to cut that particular shade, and you have to attach with the white fabric, and you have to perform the test. Grayscale for staining. Same way as we discussed earlier, grayscale for color change, for staining also same method you are following, but here we are going to use multi-fiber which contains acetate, cotton, acrylic, polymer, polyester, and wool. So for sometimes when we are going to wash, we are not going to wash only cotton fabric. In that bunch of cloths, all type of fiber are mixed, all type of fabrics are mixed. So in that case we have to assess the bleeding for all different types of fabric, so only you get the clear picture how the color is bleeding from the base fabric. Various constraining pair of chips are given, same as earlier said, 5 to 1. Now, 5 means good and 1 means poor. This is the example for multi fabric strip. You can clearly see there are different fabric strip like acetate, cotton, nylon, polyester, and acrylic, and wool. This fabric is attached to the fabric which we are going to test, and 4 sides are stitched, and we have put in the laundrometer after frequent washing and with certain temperature and detergent and time. We are going to take out the sample and dry it, and we are going to assess by using grayscale. So now another important thing: color portion to rubbing, otherwise it's called color portion to cracking. This is happened because of frequent upgrade of garment in various metallic parts and other wooden parts. So the rubbing of colors is called cracking. That is, the color is stripped from the fabric because of rubbing action. Fabric with large amount of surface dyes like dark color cotton fabric tend to have poor color fastness to cracking. So whenever you go for depth shade like navy blue or black or something like that, there will be lot of dye stuffs in the fabric that obviously will come out because of upgrading in different parts. Sometimes in order to increase the depth of the color, surface dyes are not washed off. sometimes poor washing. After dyeing, we have to wash 3 or 4 times. You have to wash to remove the unfixed color. Sometimes people not wash, so that color going to be stripped from the fabric because of rubbing. So this is a typical croc meter. You can see very clearly that there are various components in the croc meter. Platform top, there is a clamp. Below the clamp, we can fix the fabric what we are going to test, and in the below basic platform we can fix the white undyed strip of fabric, and we are going to make movement of that top arm left and right about 8 times. So after that we remove the fabric and we check with the help of grayscale. We check the color shade difference and staining on the white fabric. So both the things we do as early stated in the color first to washing. Full test procedure, cut two specimen of a measurement 8 inch into 8 inch and place on the test specimen on the croc meter. This is the white color fabric, and cut the base fabric that also fixed in the top arm of the fabric. Now after fixing everything, just rotate the instrument so the top arm going to move left and right. So 8 times you have to rotate the instrument. After that, remove the sample and check the color variations, shade variations, and color bleeding or staining in with the help of grayscale. So another very important thing, color fastness light, because the whole day the garment going to be exposed to the light, the sunlight. So this is also very important factor because of light going to influence the variations of the color. This is the resistance of the sunlight depends upon the season. There is summer, winter, autumn, there are 4 or 5 seasons. So this is going to influence the color variations in the garment and intensity of light. Sometimes sun going to be very hot or very cool, that going to influence and attitude and internal properties of sometimes fabric properties is going to influence them. They are going to react with the sunlight and going to make a change in color difference and distance from the equator. So the light fastness, there are two methods: original standard method, sunlight method. Samples are placed in a glass cabinet and exposed to sunlight from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. It is time consuming process because for long time the sample has to be placed and the result will get after one day. So this is a time consuming process. Nowadays people are going for weatherometer and fadometer, mostly widely used instrument. Both these instruments are different light sources and the temperature and humidity and controlled within the machine. Specimen placed around the light source and remains there until the end of the test. Then evaluated as a change of color in resulting from radiation. Weatherometer is newer and more versatile machine. It enables specimen to be sprayed with the water during the test if desired. Sometimes when raining, both sunlight and rain will be exposed to the fabric will be exposed for the both sunlight and rain. So in that case, we can use weatherometer where we can get the accurate picture of color variations in the fabric. It also able to alternate light and dark periods in continuous light exposure if not desired. The conditions are used in the weatherometer to test the fabric for such end uses as outdoor finishes, tents, and rainwear. So it very clearly stated that the name is a weatherometer, where we can expose the fabric not only to light in real atmosphere conditions where rainfall and weather changes, everything can be incorporated in this test. Instrument and fastness, both the machine have either a carbon arc lamp or xenon arc lamp. So xenon arc lamp is costly than carbon arc lamp. Degree of fastness required depends on end use. For example, coat material should have more color fastness than the colored dress set. Similarly, clothes not intended to worn outside should be have certain color fastness to enable drying in the sunlight. This is a typical diagram showing the weatherometer. This is a new version. It enables the specimen to be sprayed with water. These things are discussed earlier. We can change the water intensity and the time and the different color intensity. So everything you can vary in this weatherometer. Two testing methods are used. One is time method and standard fading method. The time method, the specimen is exposed to the light for particular amount of time. After the termination of the time, the specimen is taken out and evaluated. The only disadvantage of the method is specimen is not exposed to the same amount of light each time the test is performed. A very simple test procedure, we are going to cut the specimen 2.5 inches to 8 inches with longer dimension in lengthwise. mount the specimen in the cardboard holder and remove the perforated strips so that the half of the specimen will be uncovered. So this is very much needed because we have to compare with the control sample. So that's why we are exposing half and other half is not exposed. Insert the cardboard holder into the metal holder and place into the machine. Expose the specimen for 20 hours. At the end of the desired exposure time period, remove the specimen and allow it to relax in the dark at the room temperature for at least 2 hours in order to regain the moisture from the air. Then only you can get the real result. Using the grayscale for evaluating the color change, determine the color fastness rating in the test fabric. So this is the AATC test method 16. Samples are textile material tested and agreed upon the comparison standards. So already standards developed by AATCC, we are going to expose the sample and we are going to compare with the existing sample. The aerial method, we are partly exposing the specimen and another part is not exposed. By that we are comparing. Here already standards are existing, we are comparing with that standards. So the final one is color fastness perspiration. This is nothing but because of sweat happening in the body. This can be cause the fabric to change in color as well as resulting in the staining of the adjacent material. The test is an actual at, so that is at body temperature. 38 degrees centigrade is the body temperature. So we are going to perform the test at 38 degrees centigrade for 6 hours. Here also we are taking the multi-fiber fabric because we are not only wearing cotton fabric. We are going to have different types of fabric like wool, acrylic, acetate. So we are testing the sample with multi-fiber fabric. After the test is completed, the specimen is taken out. With the help of the rating scale, we are going to rate whether the color is bleeded or there is a shade difference. If rating is 5 means very good, rating 1 is very poor. This is the typical diagram for perspirometer where we are having a set of loads. See, in the bottom, the platform, we are going to place the specimen. On top of that, we are going to add weights. The purpose of adding weight is that going to give real picture of how far the specimen is react with alkali and acid. We are going to treat the specimen in alkali as well as acid and we are going to see how much because in fact there may be alkali condition and acid condition. The both the condition we are going to test and we see how much staining and shade difference going to happen in the fabric. Cut the specimen, this is the simple procedure, cut the specimen for 2/4 inch into 2/4 inch, cut the multiply fabric to 2 into 2 inches, immerse the test sample and specimen in the acid solution for 15 minutes, withdraw the fabric and remove any excess, that is very important, we have to remove the excess liquid, place the specimen on the tester, load the tester with 10 pounds of pressure, that is very important, place the loaded tester on oven at least at 100 degree Fahrenheit for 6 hours, remove the test specimen, dry at room temperature and compare with the grayscale. This is the method prescribed by AATCC, method 61. In the 2010, they have developed this system. Specimen of colour textile in contact with other fibre material, wet out in acid solution, subjected to fixed mechanical pressure and allowed to dry slowly and slightly elevated temperature. After conditioning, the specimen is evaluated for colour change. So, in this lecture, I summarize the thing like that. We have discussed so many things like what are the various color fastness test is carried out for textile material, and we have defined what is color fastness. Color fastness is nothing but the ability of dye or pigment stick on the fabric even after repeated laundering or washing or rubbing or light or by sweat. So how far the fabric color is not bleeding or not changing or not staining, that is the ultimate purpose of discussing this chapter. So the 4 testers very mandatory recommended by the buyer, that is color fastness to washing, color fastness to light, color fastness to rubbing and color fastness to perspiration. So the with this if the tester carried out carefully, we can ensure that the quality of garment is up to the requirement of the customer. Thank you.